I'm now going to talk about information divergence, which we will often abbreviate as just divergence, which is also called Kullback-Leibler divergence or KL divergence, which is also called relative entropy. What information divergence is going to give us is a way to measure how different two distributions are in terms of bits. This video is going to build off my previous video on entropy. So as a reminder, the entropy for a distribution Px is going to be given by an expectation. Okay? We're taking an expectation with respect to distribution Px. So these give us the weights that we're going to be using when computing the expectation, and the labels, or you can think of it as the numbers that we're actually computing the weighted average for, this is just the Shannon information content of seeing the outcome little x. So to introduce some new notation, what I'm going to do is remove these x's here. And the idea is that we're going to think of random variable x as possibly coming from two different distributions, which is why we're removing the x here, because we're going to give another distribution that's possible for x. And so here, and we're going to have this equal to the expectation of, we're going to treat random variable x as being drawn from this distribution little p, and what's in here is the Shannon information content for seeing x. Okay, so log base 2 of 1 divided by p of capital X for the random variable. Sometimes we'll abbreviate this as just expectation with respect to p of log base 2 of 1 over px, where it's clear that the random variable inside the expectation, which here is x, is drawn from this distribution, p. And the basic idea of information divergence is to look at the penalty we pay if we were to use a different distribution to encode a sample from distribution p. So here, if we had a weighted average, so let's say the true distribution is p, so x is drawn from p, but now I'm going to measure how many bits are needed to store each of these samples from p using a different distribution q. Okay, so you can think of this as we're going to try to store the samples using the number of bits for distribution q. Okay, and q and p are distributions defined over the same alphabet. So script x. So this thing we would write as the expectation of x is drawn from p, but we're looking at the Shannon information content according to distribution q. Okay? So a fundamental result in information theory is that we can't hope to actually compress IID samples from distribution p better than this entropy rate, okay, this amount of bits. At some level, it actually is how many bits we need to store on average. And so if we were to encode using a different distribution, we're going to have to use more bits. And I'll give an example soon to make that concrete. Now I'm ready to define what information divergence is, which is denoted as the divergence between P and Q is given by this thing, the average number of bits to store a sample from P using distribution Q, minus this thing up here, the entropy of P. So the average number of bits needed to encode a sample from P using the distribution for P. This here is the information divergence between P and Q. So this thing again is going to be at least zero because this term on the right here is the minimum number of bits we need on average. And so if we use any other distribution to encode, we're going to pay a penalty, and the penalty is going to be in terms of bits, okay? So number of bits here using distribution Q minus number of bits here using distribution P. Okay? Oftentimes, a more compact way to write this, of course, is to combine these two summations into one, in which case, by property of log, we can write log base 2 of, so there's a minus, so this Px goes into the numerator, so log base 2 of P of x, divided by q of x. So of course we can write this as the expectation of x being drawn from p of log base 2 of px divided by qx. Okay? So two important properties. First, an extremely important property is that if you get that the divergence between p and q is equal to zero, then this happens if and only if P and Q are the same distribution, which I'll write as 3 equal sign. And this just means that the probability tables P and Q agree on every entry. So P of X is equal to Q of X for all X. It's like a distance. When the distance is 0, then the two things that we're measuring the distance between are actually the same. This property is called Gibbs inequality. So that's nice. However, divergence is not like distance because in general, the divergence between P and Q is not equal to the divergence between Q and P. Okay, let's work out an example that will make this very clear and also give you intuition for what this is measuring in terms of bits. I have two distributions, P and Q, over a coin toss, so I'll have heads and tails. And so for distribution P, we're going to have probabilities half and half, and for distribution Q, we're going to have probabilities 1 and 0. And so the divergence between P and Q is going to be given by, so we're going to be using this equation up here. So the first thing is going to be the probability of heads according to distribution P, which is half, times log base 2 of probability of heads according to distribution P, which is half, divided by probability of heads according to distribution Q, which is 1, plus, and then probability of tails using distribution P, so half, log 2 of, again, probability of tails using distribution P, so half, divided by the probability of tails using distribution Q, which in this case is 0. Okay, so this thing here blows up to infinity, and so the divergence between P and Q is infinity bits. What just happened? Well, what happened was that we're sampling from distribution P, where it's possible that we get tails, but distribution Q has no way of storing tails. Okay, so we get hit by a penalty of infinity bits. In contrast, if we looked at the divergence between Q and P, we're going to first have the probability of heads according to distribution Q, so 1 log base 2 of probability of heads according to distribution Q, so 1 divided by probability of heads according to distribution P, half, plus, and then 0, which is the probability of tails according to distribution Q, log base 2 of 0 divided by the probability of tails according to distribution P, which is half. And if you remember from the previous video on Chen and entropy, 0 log 0 we're going to take to be 0. So this thing goes away to 0. And what we're left with is 1 log base 2 of 2, which is 1. So this thing is 1 bit. And so this isn't surprising because if we take a sample from Q, we're only going to be able to get heads because that's what deterministically happens. But when we store using distribution P, P is going to represent each possible sample of either heads or tails using 1 bit. Okay? So if you remember from the entropy video, had we sampled from Q and stored using Q, we would need 0 bits because we know deterministically 1 happens. However, if we sample from Q but store using P, it's going to cost 1 bit. Okay? So again, here you can think of this as this is the penalty you pay for storing a sample from Q using distribution P instead of using distribution Q, okay, which is 1 bit.